Hi friends, in this video, we're going to explore what makes this metal sculpture move for over 20 minutes. I should tell you that this sculpture has no electric motor, no magnets, and nothing else. It's just the simple laws of physics that make it move. This sculpture is actually a pendulum, built with a circular pivot point and two weights on either side, connected to the central rod by two arms. The key point is that this side is just slightly heavier than the other. Need reliable parts for your next DIY or engineering project? JLCMC makes it easier than ever to get what you need, fast, affordable, and all in one place. Whether you're building, prototyping, or upgrading, they offer a massive selection, and even custom solutions tailored exactly to your specs. No more delays, no more overpriced suppliers, just smart sourcing and fast worldwide delivery. And here's a bonus. If you're a new user, you'll get a $70 coupon just for signing up. So why wait? Power your next project with confidence and with JLCMC. Visit jlcmc.com today. Links in the description. When we move the sculpture out of its balanced position, the change in height gives both weights gravitational potential energy. At this point, gravity pulls both weights downward. That's their weight force. But since both are connected to a circular pivot rod, their motion becomes rotational. Now, because the side with the figure creates slightly more torque than the other, it can overcome the downward pull on the opposite side and push it back the other way. This small difference in torque is what causes the sculpture to move in a slow and gentle motion. After releasing the sculpture, the gravitational potential energy begins converting into kinetic energy. At the lowest point, the potential energy is zero, and kinetic energy is at its maximum. As it continues moving upward, the kinetic energy starts turning back into potential energy, but now in a slightly smaller amount than before. That's because some of the energy is lost as heat due to friction at the pivot point and air resistance acting on the sculpture. This cycle keeps repeating until all the energy eventually dissipates as heat, and the sculpture comes to a stop. Here, you can clearly see that the greater the weight difference between the two sides of the pivot rod, the faster the movement becomes, resulting in shorter oscillation time. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.